Shalom, shalom. We are beginning the Limud of Tanakh, starting, of course, with Sefer Yehoshua. And the hope would be we would complete a perek within approximately 15 minutes. And Sefer Yehoshua begins with the death of Moshe Rabbeinu. Moshe Rabbeinu died, according to our Chachamim, on the 7th of Adar. And the Torah says in Parshas Osa Bracha that Bnei Yisrael were mitabel. They mourned over Moshe Rabbeinu for 30 days. And after the 30 days, so this is the 7th of Nisan, and the Avelus of Moshe is over, Hashem now appears to Yehoshua ben Nun, who was the successor of Moshe. He was Moshe Rabbeinu's closest disciple. And the Pasuk says, V'hi acharei mot Moshe Eved Hashem, when Moshe, the Eved of Hashem, the servant of Hashem, died, V'yomer Hashem el Yehoshua ben Nun mishareit Moshe lemor, Hashem now communicates, after the Avelus of Moshe Rabbeinu for 30 days, to Yehoshua ben Nun, who is the servant of Moshe. There are 2 points even in the first pasuk that I want to talk about. First of all, Moshe Rabbeinu is called the Eved Hashem. This is a relatively rare title that is given. The Radak says a beautiful thought, that Moshe is called Eved Hashem because by an Eved there is a halacha, mashekana Eved kana rabba. Whatever an Eved acquires, whatever he finds, whatever he owns, belongs to his master. Moshe Rabbeinu was blessed with many, many kochos, the kochos of prophecy, the kochos of brilliance, of leadership. But every single koach he had belonged to Hashem. He gave to Hashem. He is an Eved Hashem because nothing was for himself. Mashe kana Eved kana rabba. Rav Elchanan Wasserman writes, based on this Radak, that every single person, when the Rambam writes in Hilchos Tshuva, every person can be as righteous as Moshe Rabbeinu. That doesn't mean I can be as righteous as Moshe. That's not possible. But what it means is, just as whatever Moshe Rabbeinu had, he gave to Hashem, whatever we have, even though it's much, much less than Moshe, we too can give to Hashem, and that is called Eved Hashem. And that's what the Rambam means in Hilchos Tshuva, that each person can be like Moshe Rabbeinu in the Bechina of Eved Hashem. The second nekuda I want to point out is the title that is given to Yehoshua. Yehoshua is not described as the Talmid of Moshe. Yehoshua is described as Misharet Moshe. He is described as the servant of Moshe. According to Chazal, that would mean that Yehoshua would pick up things in the Beit HaMidrash, whatever that would mean exactly. He would pick up the Svarim. He would arrange the chairs. He did a lot of physical things that assisted Moshe. And Chazal say, Gadol Shimusha Yoser Melimuda, that serving the Talmud Chacham can even be greater than learning Torah from the Talmud Chacham. Because when you serve the Talmud Chacham, you are learning from every aspect of his life, not just his shiur, not only his chidushei Torah, but from everyday life, the way he eats his meals, the way he talks to people. And Mimela, Yehoshua ben Nun, had a special zechus of being Mesharet Moshe. But be it as it may, after this happened, Hashem now speaks to Yehoshua on the 7th of Nisan. Moshe Abdi Meis, Moshe my servant died, Viata, and now Kuma Voret Yarden Azeh. It is now time to cross the Yarden. Remember, the Jewish people are in Arvot Moav, the plains of Moav, on the east bank of the Jordan. And they're going to cross the Yarden to conquer Eretz Israel. And Hashem is saying, you're going to cross the Yarden soon, Atav Cholam Azeh, you and all of the nation, El Aretz, to the land, Asher Anochi Nosein Lahem Bnei Yisrael, that I am giving to Bnei Yisrael. This is Eretz Yisrael, the land that Hashem promised to the Avos and promised to the Yetzei Mitzrayim. Of course, remember that the generation that left Mitzrayim died over 40 years. This is the new generation that was either born in the desert or that was less than 20 years old at the time of Yetziat Mitzrayim. And not only will I give you the land, but Hashem makes an additional promise. Kol makom asher tidrach kafrach lechem, every place that your foot steps on, bo lachem nisativ, I have given it to you. And Chazal learned out a very important halacha, that not only is the area that is within the boundaries of Eretz Yisrael have the Kedusha of Eretz Yisrael, but even if Am Yisrael conquers land outside of the boundaries of Eretz Yisrael, right? The boundaries are given in Parshas Masai, that these are the boundaries that have we're obligated to conquer. But if we conquer areas outside of those boundaries, they also have Kedushat Eretz Yisrael, and that is derived from this pasuk, Kol Makom Asher Tidroch Kaf Ragleichem Bo Lachem Nesativ. Tosfos learns, and the Rambam learn, however, that that rule only applies after we have conquered everything within the boundaries of Eretz Yisrael. Then we have the din of Kol Makom Asher Tidroch Kaf Ragleichem. Until we conquer, areas outside of that mandatory conquest do not have Kedusha. And then Hashem says, Kasher Dibarti El Moshe, all that I said to Moshe. And then it gives us the boundaries, Bekitzor. The boundaries in detail are given in Parshas Masai at the end of Bamidbor. Here there's more of a general description. Me'amidbor v'halvanon hazeh. From the Midbor, this is the Sinai Desert near Egypt. And Levanon is the northern boundary. So from north to south. Ad ha-Nahor ha-Gadol Nahar Pras, as far east as the Euphrates River. Again, let me just point out, that is a lot bigger than the boundaries of Medinat Yisrael. So the boundaries of Eretz Yisrael are way, way beyond the state of Israel. Kol Eretz Achitim, the land of the nation of the Chiti, that's one of the seven nations, Viada Yama Gadol, and to the west, it is to the Mediterranean, Mevo HaShemesh, where the sun sets, that's to the west, Yiyeh Gevulchem. And he promises Yoshua that nobody will be able to defeat Am Yisrael. Lo yisyatzev ish lefanecha kol yemechayecha. No one will stand up against you. Now this means a double meaning. Just as in terms of the umot ha'olam, you will have nitzachon, it also means your leadership will not be challenged by other Jews. Lo yisyatzev ish is both within B'nai Yisrael and outside of B'nai Yisrael. Kol yemechayecha. Kasher hayiti im Moshe eye imach. Just as I was with Moshe, I will be with you. Again, we have to pause here for a moment and just imagine how difficult Yoshua's job is. Besides the immense challenge of leading a nation and conquering Eretz Yisrael, which is ruled by 31 Canaanite kings who are fierce and strong warriors, look at whose shoes he's filling. He's filling the shoes of the greatest of the Nevi'im, the greatest leader that we ever had, Moshe Rabbeinu, who spoke to HaKadosh Baruch Hu, panim el panim, who brought the Torah down to Am Yisrael, who did the Ten Makos in Mitzrayim and the Kriyas Yamsuf. Talk about big shoes to fill. One could imagine that Yoshua is frightened. How will he possibly be able to achieve that role? And Hashem gives him chizuk and comfort. Kasher hayisi im Moshe, as I was with Moshe, eye imach, I will be with you. Lo arpecha, I will not let you be weak. V'lo ezveka, I will not abandon you, I will not forsake you. Chazak v'yamatz, be strong, have courage. Ki ata tanchil et ha'am hazeh, you will give the people their inheritance in Eretz Yisrael. We know, Chazal figure out the chronology, we'll see it later in the book, that for 7 years it took to conquer the land, and then it took 7 years to divide the land among all of the different Shvatim and the families within the Shvatim. That was a very complicated process. We'll get into it later. But Hashem is essentially telling Yoshua, not only will you conquer the land, but you will supervise the distribution of the land that I promised to their forefathers, Avraham, Yitzchak, and Yaakov. Now, the first chazak v'yamatz is the courage and the strength and the bitachon to engage in a difficult war against very powerful nations. But then, in Pasuk Zion, there is a second chazak v'yamatz. Because the purpose of political leadership is not simply to conquer land, but is to keep the Torah, keep the mitzvah, serve Hashem. And that's the second Chazak V'Yamatz. Yes, Chazak V'Yamatz to be a great military leader. But there's a second Chazak V'Yamatz. Ma'od, and here it has the word ma'od, be extra careful about this. Lishmor la'asot kechol ha-Torah, to observe and fulfill and obey all the commandments of the Torah. Asher Tzivcha Moshe Avdi, that Moshe, my Eved, again, Eved Hashem, commanded you and all of Am Yisrael, Al Tosur Mimenu Yaminu Smol, do not turn away from the Torah to the right or to the left. Laman Taskil B'chol Asher Teilech, because if you want to have Hatzlacha, if you want to have success, it will not be a function of your army, your military strength, or your charismatic leadership. It will be because you are Mekayim, the mitzvos of Hashem, and you bring Am Yisrael to that fulfillment. Then we have a very famous pasuk, Lo Yamush Sefer HaTorah Zemi Picha, the Torah should never depart from your mouth. The words of the Torah should always be on your lips. And by the way, this is understood as not only directed to Yoshua ben Nun, although Hashem is speaking to Yoshua. This is really a mitzvah on all of us, that we should be constantly involved in saying and thinking about words of Torah. V'hagisa bo yaimam v'layla. One should ponder, think, concentrate about the words of Torah. Night and day. This is what we say every day in Arvit. G'hem chayeno v'yorech yameno. The Torah is our life and the length of our days. Uvahem nehegeh yomam v'layla. And in the Torah we will think day and night. This is taken directly, v'hagisa bo yomam v'layla, l'man tishmor lasais. And then it adds another nekuda, that the ikar tachlis of learning is not just to learn intellectually, but lilmaid almanas lasais, to do the mitzvahs, k'chol ha-kasuv bo, and again Hashem repeats, ki oz, when you're that type of leader, tatzliach Esther Achecha, your derech in life will be successful. Uz taskil, and then you will wisely know how to lead. Halo tzivisicha chazak v'yamatz. And then Hashem repeats a third time. Be strong and have courage. Al tarots, do not be afraid. Al techas, do not be broken. Ki imcha Hashem aleikecha b'chol asher teilech. Hashem is with you wherever you go. So this is HaKadosh Baruch Hu's message of hope, of bitachain, that as great as the challenge is of filling Moshe Rabbeinu's shoes, Yoshua will be given that ability. So now we switch to Yoshua. Vayitzav Yoshua, Shetrei Yom Lemor. Yoshua then commands the Shotrim. The Shotrim are like the Gabayim, the attendants, the policemen, the enforcers. Ivru b'keref ha-machane, go through all of Am Yisrael, publicize. V'tzivu es'om le'mor, tell the people, hachinu lechem tzeda, prepare for yourself food, pack up, we're going to be moving soon, from Shittim. Shittim is their last camp in Arvos Moav. Ki biyod shalosh yamim. After 3 days, we're going to cross the Yarden. Again, 7th, 8th, 9th, so after 3 days, we're going to cross on the 10th of Nisan, Atem over Misayardin Azeh, and this will be the first step, crossing the Yarden, and we're going to see that will be a great miracle, although that's not mentioned here. Lavo l'reshes esa'oretz asher Hashem elokeichem, nosein lachem l'rishta, the land that Hashem is giving you to inherit. So Yoshua's first communication is get ready to cross the Yarden, and let me point out that the phrase hachinu lachem tzeda, prepare for yourself food, has two interpretations. One, of course, is Seido L'Derech. We're going on a major trip. Be sure that you're ready for this great trip crossing the Yarden into Eretz Yisrael. But Seida can also mean Mazon Ruchani, spiritual food, because you're about to embark on a great challenge and you need Zechuyot, you need merits, you need Tshuvah, Tfilah, Tzedakah, Masim Tovim. And when we talk about preparing a Seido L'Derech, it is not just physical food, but all of the zechuyot that we need to merit Hashem's bracha. So that is Yoshua's message to Bnei Yisrael, and that is delivered not directly. Yoshua did not have a public address system to speak to 600,000 people. He sent the Shotrim to be Mefarsem. But the next message Yoshua gives himself, not through Shotrim, and that is to Ruveni v'Lagadi, V'lechatzi Shevet Menashe. Again, you have to remember the Torah. If you remember, The east bank of the Jordan, there were large territories that were conquered from Sichon Melech Amori and Og Melech HaBashan. Moshe Rabbeinu waged war against them, and Moshe Rabbeinu conquered that territory. And Reuven, Gad, and Chatzi Shevet Menashe wanted to live there because there was a lot of grass, it was very fertile, they had a lot of cattle, and they requested that they live east of the Yarden in the land of Sichon and Og. Moshe Rabbeinu gave them teichacha. He says, how dare you sit here when your brethren are going to go to war? And they made a promise to Moshe Rabbeinu that we will leave our women and our children and our cattle and our flocks, Eiver LeYarden, on the east bank of the Yarden, Eretz Sichon V'Og, but we will cross over with Achenu B'nai Yisrael. We will fight, we will risk our lives, and we will not return to our land east of the Jordan until all of Bnei Yisrael have conquered Eretz Yisrael. And Moshe Rabbeinu gave them Eiver LeYarden on a condition, on a Tanai, that they fight with their brethren and they cross. So now Yehoshua is reminding them of that promise. Yehoshua, and of course this is so important, that Yehoshua does not send Shotrim. Yehoshua speaks to them directly, to Reuven, Gad, and Chatzi Shevet Menashe. Zachor es hadavor asher tzivu eschem Moshe eved Hashem lemor. Remember what Moshe said to you. Hashem Elokeichem iniach lechem. God has given you rest. You have gotten your territory east of the Yarden. Nosan lechem es aretz azos. But nisheichem tapchem umiknechem. Your wives, your children, your cattle, yeshvu biaretz. They can dwell in the land asher nosan lechem Moshe be'eber ha-Yarden v'atem. But you, the men, Tavru Chamushim, you must come with your arms, your clay Zion, Lifnei Achechem, together with your brethren. And Lifnei Achechem literally means even in front of your brethren, meaning you will fight even more than them. You will be Moser Nefesh for Klal Yisrael, Kol Giborei Achayel, Vazartem Osam. Ad Asher Yoniach Hashem L'Achechem Kochem, and you will do so until Hashem gives Menucha to your brethren, the way he gave it for you, v'yorshu gam hema es ha'aretz, and when they, the rest of Am Yisrael, inherits the land, asher Hashem Elokeichem nosein lahem, then, only then, v'shavtem li'aretz Yerushaschem, you will return to the land of your inheritance, that's the land of Sichon and Og, east of the Yarden, v'yishtem osa, you will inherit it, asher nosan lechem Moshe eved Hashem be'ever ha'yarden, that Moshe had given you, on the other side of the Yarden, actually that's the side they're still on, Mizrach HaShemesh, to the east, the Yanu es Yoshua Lamer, and the answer to Yoshua, Kael Asher Sivanu Nasa, everything that you command us, we will do, V'el Kael Asher Tishlachenu Nelech, and wherever you send us, we will go, Kechael Asher Shemanu El Moshe, just as we listen to Moshe, Kein Nishma Elecha, Rak Yi Hashem Elokecha Imach, may Hashem be with you, Bahatzlacha, Kasher Haya Im Moshe, as he was with Moshe. And the Reuven and Gad, and Chatzi Shevet Menashe, pledge allegiance to Yoshua as leader. And they say, Kol Ish Asher Yamre Et Picha, anyone that rebels against you, V'lo Yishma Es Tevrecha, does not listen to you, L'chol Asher Tetzavenu Yumas, shall be put to death. Again, Chazal see this as a halacha. Yehoshua had a din of a melech, because he was, after all, the leader of Am Yisrael. And the halacha is, Mayreid b'malchus, one who rebels against the decision or the order of a king, is chayav misa. And interestingly enough, the makor that a Mayreid b'malchus is chayav misa is from the statement of Reuven Gad and Chatzi Shevet Menashe, when they said, Kail ish asher yamra es picha v'lo yishmas tevarecha yumas, and they himself give Yoshua a bracha, just as Hashem had given him the bracha three times, chazak v'yamatz, be strong, have courage. Let me just mention Derech Agav, Rav Tzadok of Lublin says, not about this, but it's a general idea, kishem shechayev adam lahamin b'kodesh baruch hu, kachu chayev lahamin b'yatzmai. A person, just as a person must have emunah in HaKadosh Baruch Hu, as the Kel Yachel, you have to have emunah in yourself, that if Hashem has given you a tafkid, you will have the tools to be able to keep that tafkid. And that's chazak v'yamatz. Have emuna in Hashem. Have emuna in your kayach to do what Hashem has given you a mission to do. That is the end of Perek Aleph.